Hello friends, welcome to my exam coaching classes once again. So today in this video we are going to discuss about the equations, how to solve equations. When we talk about equations are one of the very important topic in almost every competitive exams. When we talk about equations, we have different type of equations like simultaneous equations, linear equations, then linear equations in two variables, quadratic equations, then with different types of quadratic equations, different equations we have to solve. So in this video we are mainly focusing on quadratic equation. Why? Because quadratic equations are one of the very important topic in almost every competitive exams. So we have different type of quadratic equations. So let us solve some of the important quadratic equations. Before going to solving quadratic equations, solving an equation means what? Solving an equation means an equation will be in any variable like x quantity or y quantity or p quantity, some unknown quantity. Finding the value of that unknown quantity, that is called solving an equation. So we have some of the equations are given in the board: x square plus 11x plus 30 equal to 0, y square plus 12y plus 35 equal to 0. Here you can see these are examples for quadratic equation. How do you understand whether it is a quadratic equation or a linear equation like that? So let us talk about quadratic equation now. If the degree of the unknown quantity, here you have y square, y and a constant, x square, x and a constant, anything in this format having a degree maximum 2, such equations are called quadratic equations. So when we talk about quadratic equations, a quadratic equation having degree 2, that is power 2, and the equation will have this. When you solve this equation, the value y will have two different values. Similarly, x square plus 11x plus 30 equal to 0 is a quadratic equation. Why it is a quadratic equation? Because we know the degree is 2. So when I solve this equation, I will get two different values for x. So how to solve this quadratic equation? And we have different methods. I am talking to you in the shortcut method in this video. So using shortcut methods, how we can solve this equation and how we can find out the value of x, that is what we are going to do in this video. Before going to these questions, let us understand what is the general formula of a quadratic equation and how it is formed. So when we talk about the general formula of a quadratic equation can be expressed as ax square plus bx plus c. Now here you can see ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0. Now here you can see x square, x and a constant. Here if you see x square, x having power 2, here having x having power 1, here x having power 0. Anything power 0 is taken as 1. So x power 0 is 1. So c x power 0, that is c into 1. So it is c only. Okay. So ax square plus bx plus c equal to 0 is the general formula of a quadratic equation. So now second thing what you need to understand is, when you compare this with these equations, here before x square there is number 1 x square. So when I talk about 1 x square, when I compare this with this equation, the value of a is 1 here, the value of b is 11 and c equal to 30. So sometimes a is 1, sometimes a is any other number. So we have to solve it in a different way, and when I take any number here, then I will tell you how to solve such type of questions. Here we have a is equal to 1. Here also you can see y square. How many y square? 1 y square. So here also a is equal to 1. So this is a general formula of any quadratic equation: ax square plus bx plus c. So now further, when we go deep into it, you can do it. When you solve it, you will get two values for x. So that can be written as x square plus sum of the roots into x plus product equal to 0. So this is one of the very important concept, students. If you understand this, then only you can solve this type of questions in your competitive exams. X square plus sum into x plus product equal to 0. So sum into x and product. So when you compare this general formula with this word, what we understand here is ax square, 1x square. So this term x square term is okay, equal. Here sum into x is equal to b. What is the meaning of that? B, the middle term will be the sum of two values of x. Middle term will be the sum of two values of x, and the last term c will be the product multiplication of two values of x. Is it clear? If you understand this concept, then it is very, very easy for you to solve this type of quadratic equations. Okay, so you can note this first, then we will go to the question and we will learn how to solve this type of questions. X square plus sum into x plus product equal to 0. Please note it. Okay, so now we'll go to the first question. X square plus 11x plus 30 equal to 0. This is type 1 questions, where you can see the coefficient of x square is 1, the coefficient of x is 11, and the constant term is 30. We call, along with the x square and along with the x, whatever number comes, that number is known as coefficient. It is called coefficient. So here you can say coefficient of x square is 1, coefficient of x is 11, and the constant term is 30. Here you can say the coefficient of y square is 1, the coefficient of y is 12, and the constant term is 35. So this way you have to understand it. Now what I am going to do is, I am going to solve this question, and I am going to solve this question. Here when I solve, I will get two values for x, and here when I solve, I will get two values for y. Let us see how to solve this type of questions. So here you have to see first, confirm that this number is 1. If this number is 1, I am talking about the questions which have x square coefficient is 1. When we have a number there, that type of questions we will solve later. Here always the coefficient of x square is 1. If it is 1, see the last term. What is the last term here? Last term is 30. So the 30, you have to split it into two numbers. The 30, you have to split into two numbers. When you multiply that numbers, you should get 30. When you add that numbers, you should get plus 11. What we have seen in the previous part, the general form is x square plus sum into x plus product. What does it mean? This number, this 30, you have to split into two numbers in such a way that when you multiply, you should get the product. That means when you multiply these two numbers, you should get 30. Is it clear? Okay. And second, the middle term is sum of the numbers. That means whatever number you are taking here, and when you add the sum, when you calculate, you should get the middle term 11. So which are the numbers? So we know 30 means 2 into 15. 2 plus 15, 11 you will not get. 6 into 5, 30. 6 plus 5, 11 you are getting. This you have to find out by experience, by practice only. So we know what are the factors of 30. Factors of 30, 5 and 6 are the factors of 30. So I am taking first number 6, second number 5. So now I have selected two numbers here. 6 into 5, I am getting 30. 6 plus 5, I am getting 11. So what I need to do is, I have to split this number in such a way, the sum should be the middle term and the product should be the last term. So 6 into 5, I am getting 30, and 6 plus 5, I am getting 11. So now that's all. Once you did this much, almost you have completed your question. So now you have to write this equation in such a way that x plus 6 into x plus 5 equal to 0. This equation, whatever is given to you, this can be written as x plus 6 into x plus 5 equal to 0. When you multiply this, the same you will get. From here, you have to find out the value of x. What is the first term? X plus 6 equal to 0. If x plus 6 equal to 0, that means x will be equal to minus 6. X plus 5 equal to 0, that means x is equal to minus 5. So you have solved the question and you understood how to solve it, and you also got two different values for x. So whenever you solve a quadratic equation, you will get two different values for the quadratic equation. Two values, it may be different, it can be same also. Okay, so x equal to minus 6 and x is equal to minus 5. These are the two values we got when we solved this type of question. So let us find out the value of y solving this question now. So what is the number here? 35. So the 35 can be splitted in such a way that when you multiply, you should get 35, and when you add, you should get 12. So obviously we can understand the numbers are 7 and 5. 7 into 5, 35. 7 plus 5, 12. So this can be written as what? Y plus 7 into y plus 5 equal to 0. So this equation can be written as like this: y plus 7 into y plus 5 equal to 0. If I equate this one with a 0, y plus 7 equal to 0 means y plus 7 equal to 0 will give you y is equal to minus 7. Similarly, second term, y plus 5 equal to 0 will give you y is equal to minus 5. So you got two values for y here. Each term you have to equate with a 0 and find the value of the unknown quantity. So this is the way you have to solve a quadratic equation. So I hope you understood the technique. So now we will go with the more questions. Before that, please note it. Let us go to the next question. So the next question is x square minus 2x minus 24 equal to 0 and y square plus 13y plus 40 equal to 0. So let us solve these questions in the same way what we have solved in the previous question. Here you can see the number is 24. So you have to split the 24 in such a way when you multiply, you should get minus 24, and when you add, you should get minus 2. So 24, 1 into 24, which are the different factors of 24? That is what we have to see. 24 factors are 1, 24s are 24, then 2, 12s are 24, then 3, 8s are 24, then 4, 6 are 24. So these are all the different factors of 24. Out of this, you have to select two numbers. When you multiply, you should get minus 24, and when you add, you should get minus 2. So I am taking these two numbers, 6 and 4. I am taking 6 and 4. Now you have to do little modifications here. What is the modification? I want minus 2. When you add, I want minus 2. So I will take this as minus and this as plus. So minus 6 plus 4, minus 2. Minus 6 into plus 4, minus 24. My work is done? Yeah. So this way you can split it. So now we have splitted this 24 into minus 6 and plus 4. Why we have taken minus 6 and plus 4? Because when you add these two numbers, we want minus 2 here. If I take plus 6 and plus 4, I will get a plus 10. But the required number here is minus 2. So to get the minus 2, you have to put minus 6 and plus 4. Similarly, when you multiply minus into plus, the answer will be minus. So minus 6 into minus plus 4, the answer will be minus 24. So this is done. Splitting is done. Now what is our next step? You have to write this equation as x minus 6 into x plus 4 equal to 0. Here you have minus 6. That is why I have taken x minus 6. Here it is plus 4. That is why I have taken x plus 4 equal to 0. Each term equate with 0, find the value of x. If x minus 6 is equal to 0, minus 6 will go to that side, I will get plus 6. So x will become 6. Similarly, x plus 4 equal to 0, that means x is equal to minus 4. So now I will tell you a trick. You need not to write these steps also. You can just change the sign of the value. Here if you are getting minus 6, x will be plus 6. Here if you are getting plus 4, x will be minus 4. So you can find out the answer from here itself. From this step itself, you can find out the answer. You need not to find out these steps. If the answer is, if the splitting number is minus 6 here, x value will be plus 6. If the splitting number is plus 4 here, x value will be minus 4. You can change the sign and find the answer directly. You need not to waste your time in your competitive exam. Okay, this is only for understanding the concept. I am writing all these numbers, why we are getting plus 6 and minus 4. Once you practice 3-4 questions, your concept is clear. Then from here itself, you can understand how to find the value for x. Okay, here you can minus 6 means x will be plus 6. Here plus 4 means x will be minus 4. Understood? Similarly, next, let us go to the next question. 40 is the number. So 40 can be splitted in two ways. When you multiply, I want 40. When I add, I want 13. So we know 8 and 5 are the numbers. 8 and 5. 8 into 5, 40. 8 plus 5, 13. So now x will be equal to what? This is plus 8 and this is plus 5. Here you want plus 13. So plus 8 and plus 5. 8 plus 5, 13. So you got 8 plus 5, 13. 8 into 5, 40. So we have already splitted. Now you need not to write all these steps. These steps you can write if you want to clear your concept. Once you are sure with that lines, then you can directly write the answer. How? If this is plus 8, x will be minus 8. And if this is plus 5, the second value of x will be minus 5. So since it is y here, we have to write it in y. Sorry, y. Y will be minus 8 and y will be minus 5. Okay. So this way you can easily find out the value of unknown quantity in quadratic equations type 1. This type of quadratic equations are called type 1 quadratic equations. Why we are calling these are type 1 quadratic equation? Because the coefficient of y square is 1. The coefficient of x square is 1. The coefficient is 1 means it is easy to split. If any number comes here 3y square, or if it number comes here 7x square, then the quadratic equation will be, the solving the such equations will be a little different. That type of equations are called type 2 equations that we will be solving in the next questions. Okay, so you can note it first, then we'll go to the next question. Okay, can I remove it? Thank you. So some more questions we will solve. These are very important questions taken from your previous question papers. So please pay attention. And this type of questions are normally asked in your competitive exams. You have to find out the value of x and you have to find out the value of y. A pair of quadratic equations is given to you, one in terms of x and one in terms of y. You have to find out the value of x and you have to find out the value of y by solving the quadratic equation. And then finally what you have to do is you have to compare the value of x and y. X greater than y or y greater than x. That options are given to you in your question. So accordingly you have to solve, you have to find out whether what is the condition is suitable for the given pair of quadratic equations. So let us go with the some more examples. So here the next question is x square minus x minus 30. X square minus x minus 30 equal to 0. And the other equation is y square plus 12y plus 36 equal to 0. Y square plus 12y plus 36 equal to 0. So you have two equations here. Let us solve this equation also. X square minus x minus 30 equal to 0. So the number here is minus 30. So let us split that number first. Now you understood what is the method. When I split this number, I have to select two numbers in such a way. When I multiply, I should get minus 30. And when I add, I should get minus 1. How many x here? Minus x. 1x minus 1 minus 1x. 1x square, when a number is not written means it the value is 1. If I write it 2x, here I have written 12y. 12y means the number is 12, coefficient is 12. If no number is written, no number is written means we have to take that is equal to 1. Don't take it as 0. If you take it as 0, this term will not be there. 0x does not exist. So here, if number is not written means the value is 1. So minus 1 minus 30, you have to select numbers in such a way multiplication should give you minus 30 and sum will give you, adding will give you minus 1. So obviously we can take the numbers 6 and 5. 6 and 5, 6 into 5, 30, but we want what? Minus 1. So I will take this as minus and this as plus. So minus 6 plus 5, what is the answer? Minus 6 plus 5 will be equal to minus 1. Minus 6 multiplied by minus plus 5, I get minus 30. Minus into plus, minus. So 6 into 5, 30, minus into plus, minus. So this is satisfied. Minus 6 plus 5. So minus 1. So I got this also. Now directly you will write the answer. X, first value of x will be plus 6, and second value of x will be minus 5. You need not to write the full steps. From here you can change the sign and find the answer. X is equal to plus 6, x is equal to minus 5. It is very easy, isn't it? So we'll go to the next part. 36, you have to split it in two way. When you add, you should get plus 12. When you multiply, you should get 36. 6 into 6, 36. 6 plus 6, 12. Very easy. So we'll take the numbers 6 and 6. Plus 6, plus 6. 6 plus 6, 12. 6 into 6, 36. So I am writing x is equal to minus 6. Again, x is equal to minus 6. So here you can see, I told you a quadratic equation will have two roots, two values. When I solve, I am getting value of y, 2. Two values. Here also I am getting value of x, 2. Understand, some quadratic equation will have the same value. Here also it is minus 6, here also it is minus 6. Okay, so this can be written as x plus 6 all square. This is actually x plus 6 all square. So similar, x plus 6 all square means x plus 6 into x plus 6. So when you solve a quadratic equation, the quadratic equation will have two zeros, yeah, two roots, two values. The two values can be either different or it can be same. Understood? So here you got same values, here it can be different values also. Please note. So let us go to some more examples. So the next pair of equations are x square plus 3x minus 10 equal to 0.
X square plus 3x minus 10 equal to 0,
and y square minus 11y plus 28 equal to 0.
Y square minus 11y plus 28 equal to 0.
So here you have again a pair of equations. So now what you need to do? Okay, I'm pause the video and try yourself. Okay, I'll give you 30 seconds time. Pause the video and try yourself and tell me what's the answer. You can put it in the comment box. Over? Okay, let us solve it. So now the number is 10. So 10 you have to split, minus 10. Minus 10 you have to split in such a way that when you add, you should get plus 3, and when you multiply, you should get minus 10. So I am writing the numbers 5 and 2. 5 and 2, I want adding 3. So this will be plus 5 and this will be minus 2. Plus 5 and minus 2, plus 3. Plus 5 into minus 2, minus 10. So I got the numbers. Splitting this number to find out the middle term, that is the only step you have to learn by practice. This method is called splitting the middle term.
So now you can write x is equal to minus 5, and the second value x is equal to plus 2.
Here 28 I have to split in such a way that when I add I should get minus 11, and when I multiply I should get 24. So I am taking 7 and 4. 7 plus 4, 11. 7 into 4, 28. So now the problem here is I want minus 11. If I want minus 11, I will take minus 7 and minus 4. Minus 11, minus 7 and minus 4, minus 11. Minus into minus, plus 7 into 4, 28. So I can write the answer, y is equal to plus 7. And the second value, y is equal to plus 4. So this way you can solve the equation. After solving the equation in your exam, what you have to do is, you have to compare the value of x and y. Which one is greater? X equal to y, x greater than y, yeah, x less than y. Many options are given to you in your question. Accordingly, you have to compare and write the correct answer. Understood? So if you want to write the correct answer as after comparison, you should first solve the quadratic equation and find out the value of x and y. How to solve the value of x and y? It is very easy. Now you have learned it. Now we'll go to a different type of questions. All the questions what we have done till now are whose coefficient was 1. So that is type 1 questions. The next video we are going to learn type 2 questions. Okay, so prepare well for your exam. Okay, excel in your exam, and we will meet again with a new topic and new videos. Till then, take care. Bye bye.